In this clip, I wanted to kind of just capture what her hair looks like when it has been freshly retightened, and then also when it has some loose new growth. So you'll see at the top, that's clearly the part that I have yet to retighten. That's the last little section we have left to go. And what's below is what was just retightened. And yeah, I would say again, I feel like anyone who is kind of in the YouTube space, or if you're someone who like avidly watches hair videos, you probably know this already, but I'm just gonna tell you anyway. Please don't be obsessed with neatness at the roots, especially when it comes to maintaining locks, and especially when it comes to maintaining locks with interlocking. What you don't wanna do is be so obsessed with your child having super neat roots with no hair out of place that you find yourself interlocking too frequently, and then potentially damaging your daughter's hair and even your daughter's ability to grow hair because of just the trauma of just it constantly being pulled. Determine, I mean, take, you know, do your trial and error, so to speak, but determine what a good appropriate cycle for retightening your child's hair is, and stick to it, and don't adjust it just because they may have a hair that's a little bit more frizzy than it normally is. That's a great way to traumatize your child's scalp. And again, because I did have that time working professionally with people's hair, unfortunately I did have some clients who came to me with scalps that had been traumatized from their hair being pulled, or from you know, some way or another their scalp getting traumatized to the point that their hair would not grow in those areas. And sometimes these things are not reversible, so you don't as a mother want to inhibit your own daughter's hair, her scalp's ability to produce hair. So be careful about you know, the retightening. Don't be so obsessed with, you know, the neatness that you cause any sort of, even inadvertently caused trauma. Most of the time, Cruz's hair looks exactly like what you see at the top. Her retightening doesn't stay fresh for very long. I would say probably 2.5-3 weeks, maybe. And then after that, it's frizzy, and that's fine.